No. I'm waiting for Brian.
I think you need some signage.
Well, I need to deliver something.
Hello?
I bet he'll come in the other way.
Yeah, most of them do. They do. Is there anything you need for me to hand out or anything to you?
Only.
Hey.
No, I'm grabbing a staple. I'm gonna staple some of these together, so.
Okay.
You don't have enough room?
My stuff's close, too.
Okay.
I think, yeah, they should be playing around.
Is Tim coming? Tim Allen?
I told him he'd come in here. He was, since he went to the meeting last week.
Yeah. No, there's plenty. There's five members. I don't know if Ken Jarrard is. Ken and.
Ken's supposed to be coming.
Ken and Sarah came last time, and so that's seven.
What would I need to do for the assignment? Is that everything for any of these permits? Is there any chance that any of you would have to have an issue? Oh, Cindy's looking for, Brian.
Todd said he was coming. I talked to him earlier.
He did say he was coming?
He told me he was coming.
Yes.
Good.
Hello.
About 18 miles. When I first started here, it was 18 miles. You know, so. Grab it.
Yeah. Tell you what, I'm surprised how much clearing they've done out there.
So you got about.
Hey, I'm sitting next to you.
Yeah, I'm not taking your seat out.
No, sir, you are not.
Don't ruin.
But Renee, they're Italian, they live over there. Grab on, keep it down. Okay, you take it. I don't know where you live. So you gotta go away.
It's near my office. I don't know if you've ever been.
Are you in the seat?
It's near there.
That's it.
There's no good way.
It's still with my blood clot.
Yeah, but I was gonna say, in that case, then you probably want to.
So what is it you want to do?
Beaver down all the way over to PIB.
Beaver down. That's probably not a bad idea.
Head down. But at least you'd be against traffic till you got back down.
She wants an answer.
Yeah, when you are that far over.
Good point.
With regard to the fence.
It's road, I think. Do you think Cindy and Pete picked this meeting for upstairs?
I don't think so.
No.
They're in another meeting. They're having a meeting with Tom about tree stuff.
Okay, thanks.
Hello.
Hi.
What are you doing? Pretty good, about you?
Hey, but you got some for us to read.
John still out?
No, he's gone.
Go ahead.
Yeah, he's buzzing around here.
Gets fast in here.
No.
Hey, Commissioner.
I'm good. Mr. Chairman, right here.
Yeah.
Anybody heard from Todd?
Is he late?
John?
We were in a.
John said he was coming.
Meeting with planning. John said what?
He was coming.
Yeah, I talked to Todd earlier. He said he was coming.
Okay.
Buddy, you can pull up here something, Ted.
Yes, I think.
Good one, buddy.
Ken's supposed to be coming.
He's right around there.
He's got to be out there.
On the 23rd?
Last meeting.
Tim, we got plenty. Can you sit right here?
Sit right here.
You sit right there.
I wasn't sure who else was gonna be here, so.
Well, Todd, he would tell that person. Where are you?
What is it we joke, Brian? What is it we joke? You say if you always say I'm at exit 14?
That's right.
Where are you? Exit 14? Exit 14?
Oh.
Anybody need to look at the minutes from last meeting? Anybody okay?
I'm sick, buddy.
No, I'm not on the committee.
I'm just kidding.
No.
You're not either.
No.
I'm not.
I sit over here, it's fine.
Yeah, Ken's not either.
I just want to see what y'all do.
Do we have a copy of the minutes?
Yes, yeah, would you like to see them? Yes, we do.
In there to be signed, there's.
That's a set to be signed if we adopt them.
Brian, you want to call it order?
I'd be glad to. We'll call the transportation meeting to order at 4:36 for July 29th. Believe all members are present with the exception of Commissioner Levent, who is absent. First thing we'll do is adopt the agenda. Any suggested changes to the agenda? If not, we have a motion to adopt the agenda as presented.
Second.
Motion is second. Any discussion? If not, please vote on that motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? There are none. Item number three is the adoption of the minutes from the meeting of July 23rd, 2014.
Make a motion that we adopt the minutes as presented.
And I'll second that. Any discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. There are none. Item number four is discussion and possible adoption of recommended transportation bond project list. We had a good meeting at DOT. Where do we want to start? Everybody still going down there with us?
Tim.
Thank you, Tim.
John, enjoy your vacation.
I thought about you.
I bet you do.
Not much.
I bet. And Ken did such a nice little job putting together our notebook. We'll brag on him.
That's right. Thank you.
I ain't got much.
I thought it was a very good meeting.
You got a balance?
I thought that I was very pleased with it. And I think Buddy really helped us a lot.
That's for him. I had one made.
Did you get one, Nydia?
Thank you very much, Mr.
Don't you think that our objective is to come up with a list, to send it down to GDOT for them to make any?
I think they're waiting for an offer letter from the county.
Right.
To be able to agree or make changes.
And then we take that back from them, and then we have it at our next work session. I'm just trying to establish some sort of a timeline, because Ken and I talked to Barb. Ken got me on, we were both of us on the phone with him, with Barb. And Barb needed, they were going to call.
Special meeting of the Board of Elections on August 13th. And that's when they, if the Board of Commissioners is going to try and call a GO bond referendum in November, then we would need to actually do the resolution authorizing the referendum on the 12th at the work session. And then they would then have a special meeting on the 13th to actually call the election.
And then she has till the 15th to get it to Brian Kemp's office.
To get it, and get the ballots to Kennesaw.
Exactly.
That's the 13th?
That's when the Board of Elections will meet. The 12th is when we will vote on it.
12th, we have a work session?
Yes.
Okay.
So that's our timeline.
Okay.
So we talked about, Brian, you want to go over?
We talked about possible GDOT projects in priority. as far as price tag and, you know, dividing it between the county and the state. So, first one is Georgia 400. Correct me if I'm wrong, Cindy, everybody. Georgia 400, McFarland to Highway 20. Correct? I had that at 55 million. What is that?
55, so 56. I think Russell had 56 on his meeting. That's why I put 56.
So, and they were going to contribute 5 million.
Of state funds.
Of state funds to it.
Mm-hmm. Item number two was they had 420 to 369. I thought we had the Guinness Ferry interchange of 10 million.
What we talked about on from 20 to 369 was us putting money in to do the design. Mm-hmm. And then they would give us a letter
stating that basically everything will have to go through ARC, but they said in the letter that they will do everything in their power to push that project when money becomes available. So it's, you know, it used to be GDOT controlled, you know, the money, the step, which they don't. It's Toby and the governor and ARC mostly for you all. But they gave you guys assurances that that was a top priority project for them and they would do everything they could to try to get that money.
Okay, so is the McGinnis Ferry interchange in the 55 million? Or is it separate?
There was a discussion with Rudy and others that was separate, right?
Yeah.
That it was kind of a separate deal. That's why I didn't include it, because we didn't really, we talked about it briefly, but not in any detail.
But it'll have to be in the bond. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's got to be in here. Yeah. We have no other way to fund it.
What was the amount on the interchange that
10.
It was going to be local funds.
10 million.
Because on the draft list, which is still before the board, we had the McGinnis Ferry interchange, and where is it?
Under the yellow.
Yeah, that's below the yellow. We had 4 million in here.
Okay.
So if it's now 10 million local funds, then.
Wasn't it 10 million, Pete?
For the interchange our part?
Yeah.
That's what I remember.
That's what I remember too.
Now, if we're talking about back last year when we had the meeting on the interchange, the discussion was that the CIB would fund a portion of that. So what would be on the bond would only be the portion of local funds that the CIB would fund. So if the total amount you're talking about is 10 million local funds, including the CID, then you may want to divide that. I think that's why we put.
I don't think it did. I think it was separate from.
Can you find that out?
Well,
find that out?
I think we can go ahead and put it on the list and then find out the exact fund.
Well, you can change the amount. It's already on the draft list.
Yeah.
And it's 4 million. So if that dollar amount needs to change, then whenever the board addresses the draft list, then we'll need to change it on that draft list.
How was the breakdown? It's about 40 million total.
I think it was close
million.
To
right,
about 38, 39.
Mm-hmm.
Was the breakdown.
So
the right-of-way portion was going to be around 10 to 12, I think.
And were those going to be donations or not?
Well, there's been some discussion about there being some donations, but I think there also was discussion that you couldn't
take donations for federal money.
Well, you couldn't consider that. You've got a program of funding, so.
Correct.
If you do get donations in the future, then you'll save some of the money programmed for right away, but you got to program the full amount because you're going to have to make them offers because there'll be federal funds in the project and you got to follow federal funds.
So you got 38, 39, just for easy math, and call 40. We do 10, that drops it down to 30. Who gets the next piece?
Well, the discussion is we're trying to get our project framework agreement in place right now for the design.
Okay.
The design will be local and federal funds.
Okay.
That's why we're trying to secure funding from possibly the North Fulton CID to help match the design, help us with our local portion, at least half of it. What was the amount, buddy? Like close to $400,000 for local funds, and the remainder would be federal funds to complete the design. And then the the thoughts were is that it'd be all local funds for right away, and GDOT would then take on the construction fully.
So should we leave it at 4 million, or should we leave it at 10? I mean, put it at 10?
I think we...
Or we don't put anything?
I think we just leave it as a project for now.
Just leave it as a project?
The 10 project.
I don't know what funding you're expecting from CID. If you're not sure that you're going to have any funding from the CID, then you may want to put 10 in here. But if you do get funds from the CID, then...
We don't have to use all the bonds that way.
Do we know what we'll get from CID?
They're going to have a meeting Tuesday, and all they're talking about, I told John this earlier, they're proposing $200,000 toward the design. And we haven't heard anything from Milton or Alpharetta.
So we know we're going to have some local portion for the PE. Now that won't, you'll probably need those funds before you get any bond funds. So you'll have to decide how to fund that. Since there's no squash funds available for this project, then you would have to take, if any local funding is required, from the general fund somewhere. But if our portion's only 400,000 and we get 200,000 from the Snowport CID, that puts us down to 200,000. If we get some from Alpharetta, then that knocks our local portion down even more. So you're probably looking at a local portion of 200,000 or less to complete the design.
And Rudy indicated that they had met with some of those other parties and they were going to contribute.
Well, I was going to wonder, who is facilitating that? Rudy? Or who's making those phone calls?
It's been kind of a collective effort with John and Rudy and Russell McMurray. Really, Russell McMurray took the lead in trying to get everybody together, and that worked out really well.
Now we could also take contributions from landowners for the local portion as well. So if there are landowners down there that we have people in contact with that can contribute to the local match, then that on top of the 200,000 from the Norfolk CID. Basically, whatever's left, we're going to have to fund. You know, when you get the PFA from GDOT, you're going to be committing to $400,000. But we're going to have to enter into a memorandum of agreement with the Norfolk CID for what portion they're going to fund of that 400,000. But you're going to be agreeing to GDOT, you're going to pay 400,000. And where you get that from is kind of up to the county, but we think we're going to get 200,000 from the CID.
So y'all need to figure out what it is we're going to be expected, and then come back to us with the amounts, yeah. And then us figure out where we can do it.
Yeah, and Buddy just mentioned to me we'll be attending a meeting with the CID next week.
Tuesday morning is when they're going to have the vote.
When they're going to discuss.
Meanwhile, it's 400 right now. Until we see what everybody's
putting. And when you get the PFA and the county approves it, it's going to be between GDOT and the county. We're going to be agreeing to pay $400,000. So if we get $200,000 from the CID, then that
goes towards the further the project.
And if we get any from Alpharetta, then that cuts it down even more. And if we can get donations from landowners, then that would cut our portion down even more.
I think it's important to note what was said in our meeting. When we were discussing 400 on the, and y'all correct me if I heard this wrong, but we were told that on this portion of 400 from McFarland to 20, that it is on the state's plan to be done with managed lanes by beginning in the, they mentioned the year 2030. 2030 managed lanes, because I think that that's important to get the message out to people that yes, this is a bond, and yes, this does affect your taxes, but even if the state, when the state looks to do it, is not until 2030, and they're looking at managed lanes, which is going to be a fee, which is a tax as well. So I just think that's important to know.
All right.
And then how much on the design for 20 up to 369? Didn't we say 2 to 3 million?
Yeah,
2 million.
2 million.
It's a pretty straightforward. It may be cheaper than that, depending upon what GDOT lets you do as far as surveys versus GIS, that type of stuff.
And then we talked about that the state was then going to do the 369 400 intersection, make it be continuous.
They said they'd be 10 plus million for that. That's their, that's something they're paying for.
So the state's contributing that. But then we were putting in the bond from Hammond's Crossing, 306, 369 over to 9 and 369. It's 1.7 miles. Is that right? And we were contributing that, which was how much?
Roughly 15 million. Now, John brought up this question.
369, I'm sorry, just to make sure I'm clear. It was 9 to 306, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, I think it was used to, somebody was making a recommendation we need to carry that work all the way through both intersections. Is that correct?
Well, Rudy said that, okay. That we needed.
Yes.
He said that if we, it would do no good to do the continuous lanes on 369 and not take it to the intersections.
And through those intersections.
He did say through the intersections, you're correct.
Which is like 600 feet either side typically.
But it, John and I were talking about, and so Tim, it jacks up your costs a lot. I mean, the 15 million to cover that, but you may get it cheaper if you didn't do all that. And I don't know, John, you might want to answer.
And the state could still come up with funding for this in between.
Well,
this.
And we're considering Walmart is in the agreement with Walmart that they will take the right turn lane up to 400, that they have to bring that in. And now the states went back to Walmart and asked them to take the right lane if you're going toward Highway 9 to take it from where Walmart starts all the way up to Doc Holcomb's. To the Coal Mountain intersection, so that will reduce some of the cost.
Right, but we still have to put out what we believe the cost is going to be.
Yes.
You can always return the bond money if you don't use it.
Are you in,
if the project makes the list and the board approves it, and if the bond passes and those funds are available, we also have in Splosh 7, about $1 million for that intersection. I think it's $1 million or $1.5 million.
Which intersection?
Coal Mountain.
Was it on B list or A list?
I think it's on the A list. I verify.
That helps. That's
good.
But we could, instead of moving forward with that improvement, we use that for the widening project. And so if the 15 million is short,
we'll have that
to go with it.
That's good. And this helps move it up.
Yes.
Helps it be done quicker. All right, what was we talked about in the meeting about Highway 9 South, but they told us that they didn't think there was a need for us to put something on there with
they're already working on it.
That it's already
been authorized. The state has theirs.
Right.
States are going to handle Highway 9.
Right. And I think the reason they really wanted you to put your money on that 369 because they tried to move that project with federal dollars and got nowhere.
Right.
From a logical termini standpoint, basically just taking it off their books.
Right.
So.
And they desperately know. I mean, they know it's in need.
Right.
What about Post Road then?
Can I ask a question on that before you go too far? If we agree to do the 369 project, do we need to put something in the letter about them agreeing to do State Route 9 and the section of State Route 9? So that's included in whatever agreement we get with them?
I think it's probably not a bad idea.
Well, now the section state right now you're talking about, are you talking about the section from coming here up to Coal Mountain?
No,
he said specify that section.
They said phase one and two, and then they're going to do four. They're going to skip three. Is that correct? They're going to skip north, the one that goes from past Fowler Park, right? To, right.
Yeah.
For now, they are.
Right.
And that was going to be completed by 2017?
Which is a slow fall on their part.
Or started in 2017. Todd, which was it? Was it going to be completed by 2017? Or started?
I think they're talking about construction.
By 2017. Yeah.
2017 construction.
Do you remember, Tim? I think that's what it was.
Yeah.
That's what it was.
Yeah.
Construction would begin.
Yeah. Because, I mean, look. Yeah, for the state, that'd be nice.
And what sections was this again?
From 371 to Bethlehem, I believe, was the section of Coffin Tops.
Well, the four segments
under Adjourn start from the county line coming north. You got county line to McFarland to Post to Bethlehem, and then Bethlehem to 20 coming.
So we just need the state to commit that.
Well, they've already.
It's already committed.
They're already under design, and I think they've got all the right-of-way in 2015-16.
Yes, they were telling me that they're not going to truly count as phase one and two anymore. This came from the county line to Post Road is one.
Is one.
Now
they're doing this one project.
Right.
But if it will help in communicating to the public that the state is doing things, if that will help, then I agree
it's
with
become,
Tim.
All this becomes a joint effort. They're going to jumpstart a lot of their projects if we help, and then they're going to jump on board with trying to find funding quicker for all these things.
That's why I think if we make sure that the 369 continuous lane is in there, everything they're contributing needs to be, everybody needs to see that this is a partnership. It's a joint effort.
What we need now is a lot of roads really fast with our growth, and it's hard. Very hard.
All right.
I just want to be clear. We weren't talking about the nine segments north and south of Coal Mountain.
No.
We're talking about everything south of
Correct.
Coal.
Yes. Yes. The state's not.
They're
yes.
not moving forward with those segments.
No. 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 It would be our dollars that would do that 1.7 miles from Hammond's Crossing right. to. And explain that again, what you just said. Since John wasn't at the meeting about the trouble they had on 369.
Oh, he knows. Oh, I mean, he's okay. very familiar with it. So.
They really wanted us to take that project.
Well, yeah, it's the same issue on 306. That's why the section from 400 to Hammond's Cross has never been widened and won't be. It's because of logical terminal.
And that's why they see this being so good
yeah.
for that area.
Yeah.
So they don't think a logical terminal is 369? So many people turn?
No.
Wow.
They don't consider it a freight route either, and there's one
very, very, very short
trucks
routes exist.
Yeah, it's trucks all the way to 53.
Trucks everywhere.
Well, it's not, or we don't do it at all.
It's not DOT, it's federal highway.
We understand. Highway. I understand.
But yeah, and that's the same issue with 369.
Could you do something about that?
I'm on it right now.
Post was $4 million and $7 million. That was for... Yeah, land acquisitions and the plans, and I believe environmental studies, what they want is $4 million and $7 million, is that correct?
What does it say?
Well, yeah. I think what I did is I took some money off of that. You're talking about from to Kelly Mill?
Yes, to Kelly Mill.
Yeah, I think I just put in there $3 million for the design.
Because we already had $2 point something million somewhere else.
Are they not wanting to be...
2.1, Brian.
Are they not wanting to be completely shovel ready on that?
Remember they said that they could get it moved up, they felt like
on the tip, on the tip.
If we could get it, that they could get construction funds to go with it if we could get it to where the right-of-way and the design. It would be one of those shovel-ready that we could
Do you think that
get.
$3 million is adequate?
For design, yeah.
For design.
Yeah, right. But they're talking about some right-of-way.
I mean, not for
right-of-way.
Right.
What was the 2.1? That we already had in somewhere.
SPLOST project. SPLOST 6.
We have 2.1 in SPLOST 6.
SPLOST 6.
Yes.
Right. So.
It was 2.1 in SPLOST 6.
That's why that number's lower.
But that's closed down now, isn't it? SPLOST 6.
We got a cash flow.
No, you set that aside.
We're using it for cash flow. So once you use those funds and pay it back from SPLOST 7,
gotcha.
Then you should still have the 2.1 available.
Gotcha.
For post
that
road.
That gets us close to about 6 million.
That's much
I think,
better.
Didn't Dave confirm that with you, Brian?
Yes.
But getting back to your right-of-way question, when I bumped up the 369 to 15 million, I took that money off and just made GDOT responsible for the
okay.
right-of-way costs, whether they acquired or whether you acquire it. I mean, it would be funded by them.
No, they agreed. They didn't totally agree to that yet, though.
No, we didn't. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Well, and we might have to come back and add some more to that
I got
if
you.
They won't.
I got you.
But they act like, down there, I got the impression, if we were doing this, that would be, that
That's
they,
hope.
Yeah,
That's hope.
I'm hoping.
Yeah.
All right, so post is 3.8, but we've got the 2.1 in SPLOST to go with it.
Wait a minute, 3.8.
Minus the 2.1 in SPLOST, is that what you're telling us?
3.0 is what
3.0.
Okay.
It's 3.8 miles.
Yep.
Okay.
It's 3.0. Money.
But that doesn't include right-of-way.
Correct.
But Betty's going to find that out.
And that's...
Well, that's why I would just write it up. I mean, I think that's where I wrote it. Committed $3 million for design environmental, GDOT commits to pursue federal fund for remaining project costs.
Has most everything on Post Road that's been zoned in the last 7 or 8 years, have they been made to donate right-of-way? Brian, you've been here the longest on that, I think.
Yeah, in zoning conditions. you know, per hour functional.
So a lot of that's donated already, already.
60 foot from center lines where we get donated reserve, since we don't have right of way plans, you know, it's.
So a lot of that we should already own.
Well, a lot of it we should own, but we don't, what we don't know is how the road will be designed, because it won't be.
You may need a little more or less, right?
I think it's real important to these people on post for us to make sure we've got it as, that in this bond, we have got everything we need to get it accelerated.
Yes. I think Victory's already.
That section to Kelly Mill.
I mean, believe, everything in a District 1uses this as well, as they come across 20, try to cut down across, so.
Especially all those people that'll be using Casperian and I'm just bet.
I'm sorry, did you say something?
On Post Road, I see $3 million in this draft. If there's, if you're to utilize SPOSS 6 funds and at $2.1 million, and if the design environmental is $3 million, then you would only need $900,000 in bond funds. But now, if you're going to need right of way funds in the bond, if that's determined, then we would have to do a right of way estimate and figure out what that amount
would be. I'm pretty sure they threw that number out when we were meeting. That's why I think that's seven.
Right. You don't have, you have to design it, but then if the county's going to be obligated to pay for the right of way, then you need to include the bond. But that's not in here right now. But
that's something y'all need to work on.
Todd was mentioning that.
I thought they mentioned a guesstimation amount when we were down there.
Yeah, it, they said $7 million for right of way estimate.
That's what I thought.
And they said $4 million a ton. I think I was.
That's what I thought.
I think
too.
I was putting the SPLOSH money included in that $3 million. But.
Yeah, they used a $7 million and a $4 million. That's where I first said that from. He just confirmed it.
Yeah, but originally we weren't committing to do all of 369. You know, what, until we realized that they were having that environmental issue.
I understand. Okay. But you know, if you're going to want post moving, which is, right. I mean, they're going to, it's a tit for tat negotiation, I'm sure.
But I honestly believe that I could be bad fool, but I think if we get it ready.
A shovel ready is the design, environmental,
I think we'll get some money
out of ARC
and NPO, and mm-hmm. I just believe that. We just got to get it out of aspiration onto the TIF.
So where would that $72 million, not including anything for the McGinnis Ferry interchange with DOT, is that correct?
Correct.
Right. And we need to plan on something. I mean, worst case 10, best case 4, you think?
Well, like I say, it's on your draft SPOSH list. These projects are not on the draft SPOSH list.
Right.
So, how much should we put down for 936?
Whenever the board approves revisions to the draft SPOSH list, then you would add this.
Brian's
and
not including
the interchange is already on there.
It's on there.
And that number.
Very good.
What's that?
We've got $55,400,000.
Right back, the back. He's got that on that last
$2 million for the design.
It's all.
It's got
okay.
A wise man told me to break it down this way.
So you've got the 51. I thought it was 55 and 5, so it's 51 and 5. Okay.
Russell threw out the number 56 million is what their estimate was when we were there.
Okay. 50,
yes, he did.
15, 72.
Yeah.
We might as well say 10.
I'll just add another line on them.
So
be my suggestion.
Well, do you want to clarify with Russell?
That works for me.
Post Road, if you know they were going to commit to the right of way or not, or if the board's going to send it down, then you just say, you know, this much toward design, and see if they.
That's what I was
bring
suggest.
Back to us.
Right, that we want you to help out with the right of way.
Yeah.
All right, so we need to draft
and
something.
And if so, maybe 50-50, or maybe not the full amount.
We need to draft something to DOT. Right,
I would say so.
We need to draft something to DOT. Yeah. We need to come up with a list of any extra projects we might that are local and we might want to put on the bond. And then we need to talk about the language.
We got to come up with a number.
Yeah, and the language would be, and I don't know if you were here, Mr. Chairman, we were talking about it, if it's straight bond or if it's bond that rolls into SPLOST 8, that might be something we ought to think about.
I don't know that we have to do that for the bond language for a GO bond in November.
You know, that may be aspirationally what we want to do, is that we want to then use proceeds from SPOSS 8. Really, that's going to be more important on SPOSS 8, where we're telling the voters we intend to use some of these proceeds to pay back the bond that was approved in 2000.
We don't want to tell them when we put the bond out that we're targeting SPOSS 8 targets.
Yes, we can do that. I'm just saying on the ballot language. I don't think that has to be there on the ballot language, but as part of any sort of an informational package that we may roll out, we may want to make sure to tell people that we hope to not have to use property taxes to pay this back.
And then we need to look at the length of time also. We probably need a finance person down here and see if this is a 10 or a 20 year. If for some reason, SPOSS 8 did pass.
Well, I mean, what number are we talking about right now with respect to the bond, based upon these totals?
Well, right here we're 80, let's just say for round numbers, right, 80 million. And then we have this stuff here.
And that's if SPOSS stays the same.
80 and then roughly the additional 70 from the roll.
Well, 70, where did you get 70?
Well, I was talking about what we talked about last time, the rollover SPLOS projects from 5, 6, and 7.
Ballpark.
Ballpark.
Yeah, 78, another 78.
Right.
But we felt like we were okay on, I mean, we weren't looking at doing all those SPLOS rollover projects.
Oh, okay.
I'm not.
Right.
Okay.
I mean, we talked about it, and we thought that we'd be fine to let them stay.
I think we need to look at this list here.
Once you open up state highways and make them the primary bond, your secondary roads are going to clear up.
And I think we need to decide. Yeah, that's right. But John, do you mind if I just ask you and Tim about a couple of these projects, the Ronald Reagan in particular? Majors to Shiloh, is that really 24-8?
Yes, it's probably at least. That's flood, you know, it's all floodplain through there. You're building bridges and
Yeah, because it's not that much land. It's not that much.
What are you talking about?
How long a project is that?
Majors to Shiloh.
Just a couple miles,
$24 million.
Yeah, we have. In fact, those are somewhat old estimates, but that's to complete the design, acquire the remaining right of way, and the biggest cost on those projects is construction. And they are going to require individual permits, so there'll be a lot of mitigation because a lot of both of those projects are being built in floodplain and a lot of wetland impacts.
What about the same with Shiloh to McFarland?
Yes.
Do you think, I mean,
once you get through that cul-de-sac there at Bluegrass, you know, you're crossing Big Creek, so you got a bridge there. Mm-hmm. And you're crossing the Big Creek floodplain, so.
What about, are these, I know we talked about the roads that will be around that McGinnis Ferry interchange, Union Hill and.
Yeah, Lisa.
Are we including those?
McGinnis Ferry, Sargent Road to Union Hill Road, that's still a SPLOS project, right?
Yes, Union Hill.
Does that need to go on the bond?
That is a shovel-ready project, but the board elected not to fund the construction.
Of which one?
Union Hill.
Union Hill.
No.
The bridge.
No, I was talking Sargent Road to Union Hill.
McGinnis Ferry.
Oh, McGinnis Ferry.
McGinnis Ferry.
Yeah, McGinnis Ferry.
McGinnis Ferry, Sargent to Union Hill. Yes, that is. Well, what was the question again?
That is a SPLOS project.
We plan
to have funding for it.
Well, we have the only thing we funded in SPLOS right now is half of the design. So there's no right of way or construction for that project. The amount you see right here, the $18 million. That's an estimated amount for half of the right-of-way in construction. So it's $38 million is the amount for right-of-way in construction.
36.
You know, and the assumption here is that, you know, we pay for only half of it, but we got to make sure that the other half either comes from GDOT and or Alpharetta and Johns Creek.
So should it be on this list?
You know, so a question.
Not until you have agreement, in my opinion.
Now, a question for Ken is, you know, I know with SPLOS local funds, the bond's local funds too, but I've always been of the assumption that we can only spend money in Forsyth County.
Well, no, I mean, well, yes, but with an intergovernmental agreement,
we could spend money
in another county.
So, you know, what I put here is kind of dependent on an agreement that we have with those cities.
And you've seen how easy it is to get an agreement out of some of those cities. You've seen how easy that is.
Aren't you the county attorney?
Well, first of all, not in Johns Creek.
What I will tell you is Mr. Amos and Tim Merritt also attended our Northwood CID meeting when we discussed the interchange, and the city of Alpharetta councilman that was there, he brought up quickly, well, we don't need to do that without widening McGinnis Ferry back over to Sergeant Road. And I said, so we discussed that as well. And they're interested in moving forward with that project too, so.
I mean, I just don't want us to sit and get the interchange and then all of a sudden say, oh, we didn't think about those roads. We need those roads. Because what good's an interchange if we've got those little bitty tiny roads?
All right, but that's right. But I think the first thing that we need to do is get this letter to GDOT, wouldn't you agree?
Oh, yeah.
And then we.
Because you're going to need an answer well before the 12th, right?
Oh, yeah.
You're
we got to get it soon. But they understand.
Yeah.
They understand. And I'll call Rudy too.
Then we just need to go through this list and see what our, you know, our timeline is and our.
So you don't think we should go through this until we get
I'm absolutely fine with having a discussion about it, but I just want to make sure that when we leave here today, somebody's sending them a letter.
Buddy.
Whether we have to vote.
I'll draft up something.
John.
Maybe the board needs, maybe we need to, as a transportation committee, vote to ask that to happen, or that we have an understanding that something's going to get down there, hopefully by the end of the week.
Well, tell me, go over real quick, what is the objective of this letter?
First of all, they got to agree that they're willing to participate in the order that we've written down here that we discussed in that meeting with them. And they're firmly behind the projects that they say that they're going to help get the federal money for.
But what, thank you, but what are, I mean, the letter is going to say what? Forsyth County is about to do X, but as part of doing X, we need you to commit to Y.
Yeah. Right.
This is a summary of the meeting that we had. We need a letter of confirmation that this is the way
you see. If we go out for a GO bond, for this amount, we plan to fund these portions of these projects, and we are looking for GDOT to fund the rest.
Okay. My thought would be is that to the extent that you and John are able to put that letter together and work on it, I would recommend that we call a special call meeting of the Board of Commissioners to direct that letter to go down, as opposed to just it coming out of this committee, because that's basically, we're basically got a representation to a state agency of something the Board of Commissioners is about to do. And I mean, that could be a 10-minute board meeting, but that's my comfort level.
We need to get it done soon.
We could do it.
When do you think it'll be ready?
Well, my suggestion, you just have a cover letter and clean
this
up.
That's right.
Exactly.
And say this is what we've discussed.
That's right.
I mean, basically, they've already told us this is what they're doing. I mean, this was what that meeting was.
But they
about.
Wanted it in writing.
And we wanted it in writing.
And yes.
We
wanted it in writing.
We
more
go
than
out for a bond, are people who are going to vote on this, want this in writing.
Exactly. Yes. And we want to know that they're committed, to the continuous lane at 369 and to the other things that they're willing.
Again,
to
and I know this sounds kind of, pedantic, but the issue of the bond has not even come up to the full Board of Commissioners yet.
Exactly.
So, I mean, I think that would be helpful to have a special call meeting, authorize that letter, and then everything is clear what we're doing.
We wouldn't be ready, but no. We can't vote on a bond list until we get that back from GDOT.
I think we could, but I think what I'm hearing is what's driving this is the need to incentivize DOT participation in some of these, and so that would be
premature. We just got to get confirmation.
We've got a meeting Thursday night.
So we need to get it down there as soon as possible.
I would try to get it down there tomorrow.
We can have a special call.
If there's any way possible. I mean, I think between John and I, we can
hurry up,
clean this up, and let you guys look at it.
If Ken's saying a special call meeting's needed, then
is it needed?
How soon?
Yeah, it is. It is.
So
I mean, because we're about to make representations on behalf of Forsyth County, not this committee. And so I would want, we could do a special call meeting, though. We could do a special on Thursday. Easy. Thursday morning. And then hand deliver that letter down. I mean, again, I think that's probably, a 10-minute meeting, max?
Never know.
A buddy could clean that up and let you and I review it tomorrow, and then you can make what tweaks you want to it and have it ready for the board to approve Thursday morning and send it down.
You could always send it to them, tell them to anticipate this. This is the letter that's about to be ratified tomorrow morning, and we intend to ratify this tomorrow morning.
I just worry about a back and forth and how much time delay you're talking if that happens. I mean,
Well, I mean, it's Tuesday afternoon. We're talking about Thursday morning, having it down there by Thursday morning. I mean, unless DOT acts in a manner that I'm not used to them acting like.
Would it be inappropriate if we put in our motion that Mark Hamilton hand delivers it?
Well,
that was just fun for me. He might do that for you. It's Transportation Committee, for God's sakes, it might help.
But as far as the list, is the list where we're comfortable, we know what the list is?
I think with the state, to GDOT, and then we need to look at what other projects we want to put on here.
And I'll add the 400 McGinnis on this letter, as well as a State Route 9 and County Line to Bethelview.
And how broad we want to go? Is it just road? Is it sidewalk? Is it, you know, other transportation projects as well?
Do you need to confirm where they will give you these numbers, like the $2 million for the design?
That was just numbers that I came up with, that, you know, John and I talked, I gave him a four mile cost for typical type projects. I've asked John to check and make sure he's supposed to come with them.
Yeah, we just need to confirm the numbers before we send them down. I mean, I would hate to say $2 million and it's wound up being $4 million.
It is.
It shouldn't be.
It is.
No right away acquisition has to be done, it's just design. And they're doing the 369, they're doing that whole continuous lane, so that's going to pull back some.
The 400 design.
I think if Buddy could state it so as it's, that we're going to be responsible for the design environmental up to.
Right.
Or, you know, whatever.
Because if they do those continuous lane, that's going to take some of the 400, at 369.
I've just got one more question.
Yes, it will.
So if we send this letter down to GDOT, board ratifies it, goes down, and we're trying to get an answer back by August 12th, what sort of confirmation do we think GDOT?
Need an answer back by that Friday.
What kind of answer, though? I mean, do you think it'll be a yes, we're prepared to do that?
It needs to be a written response, in my opinion, from Toby Carr, the planning director and commissioner of DOT.
Well, then put that in the letter, asking him specifically to do that.
Right, both of them. I think both of them need to sign that document.
Yes.
Because state, because Toby's not over the statement it's committed or what's already been programmed for the intersection. So, but Toby's going to be the one making sure the federal money, so you're going to need both of them.
For me.
Yeah, if they're anticipated schedules, then you'll need to make note of that, and one thing that they'll need to be doing for us is providing assurances that they'll program these projects and meet certain schedules as been agreed upon.
I agree.
Okay.
That needs to be in it, definitely, because we don't want to spend the $55 million on 400 and then the 369 interchange just keeps sitting. Or we don't want to do the improvements at Hammond's Crossing and Coal Mountain and the 369 interchange doesn't get done. It needs to be done together.
Yeah, I agree completely.
It needs a timetable.
What, the continuous flow interchange, how does that fit into the project that we're talking about on 369? Because the way that's configured, that right-of-way gets real wide through there.
Mm-hmm.
Is that, are we still comfortable with our estimate, realizing how big that?
Yeah,
okay.
They said they were.
Yeah, the worst case scenario, it takes more off of us because theirs gets bigger.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and they'll be funding the right-of-way acquisition for the continuous flow.
That's right.
Exactly. That's all in their numbers.
Our project limits will be outside of the scope of that continuous flow intersection.
I think we need to be careful with that because I think if we're not careful, we move forward with that project, they're going to come back to us and ask us to acquire their right-of-way when we're going through to acquire our right-of-way.
Well, maybe they need to start their project first.
That's what they said in continuous flow, that they didn't have to acquire any right-of-way.
Oh, no. I think they're going to acquire a lot.
Oh, yeah.
I think they said
they
says why they have to.
So was that figured in their number?
And there were issues.
Yes.
They said 10 to 15 minutes.
There were issues in that area with
environmental. That's right, environmental. Oh, they said that too.
So I just think I'll be careful with that piece.
I would let them jumpstart theirs first, and then we get into our studies and our work right after that, because we know exactly where their lines are, limits are.
Yeah, our limits should start where their limits end.
That's correct, and let them start first.
Yeah. And there has been some advanced acquisition on that interchange, I know, on that northwest corner.
Ms. Mills is better. Your concern was that you get yours going, they don't do theirs. Well, let them start theirs, and we'll go right behind them. Because you know we're going to do it. We're just not sure. To make sure they get theirs started.
And I don't know how they feel about it. I mean, like, what they see should be done first. maybe you can find that out.
Yeah. Well, we could time them together, you know, but first let them identify their limits.
Correct.
And then us begin our limits where theirs end.
Yeah, correct.
But in the letter, we probably ought to say, we anticipate that you would have this under construction in 3 years from the date of the public 4 years. Yeah, we need to lock them down.
You need to lock them down on that continuous flow because I believe they should have it ready for construction within a year.
They
said they had the funding ready.
Yeah, they acted like it was a quick project.
They acted like that was a quick project that they could turn on fast.
With all state funds, they wouldn't have to go through FHWA.
They said they had the funds too.
No, it's lump sum federal.
Lump sum federal?
Yeah.
So they do have.
Yeah, they're going to follow the federal process. That's what I'm saying. I'm not.
If they're ready, they said.
Okay.
But should be able to get it complete under construction year and a half.
Buddy, did you get the comment John made about scheduling, being sure we tie them down to a schedule?
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to figure out. I mean.
On all the projects, though, not just that one.
Okay.
I think this letter, commitment letter that we get back from them ties them down not only to the funding, their commitment of pursuing federal funds, but it also ties them down, I think, to a schedule is what John was saying.
I think we should try to time down to a schedule on every project and see what the response is.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
I don't think they're going to be able to do that.
Well, they probably, I mean, I feel sure they won't on some projects, but like the continuous flow.
Oh, yeah. I'm talking more specifically about 371 and 400.
Yeah.
I mean, I think they'll be able to lock down the 9 project and they'll be able to lock down the 5.
We can try and ask them and see what the response is. We can request a time frame. See if they'll give us one.
Okay.
Doesn't hurt that.
Yeah. Even if it's 10 years, so, you know.
The only thing I need out of
we need to know
today is an estimated
dollar amount. Further out than you think, then you might want to go back to the table and you need to know.
Just because if you want me to come to the meeting on the 12th with a resolution ready to go to be adopted time sensitive. I mean, the resolution will have the ballot language in there.
Yep. Well, I think that it probably and be best if we had, I hate to say it, another meeting with some finance people here because Mr. Bruin had a death in the family and obviously out of town. And I'd hate to go down that road and be inaccurate.
Couldn't you kind of, for rough estimate about use the same thing we're doing on the $100 million park loan.
That's what I thought, exactly.
Yeah.
It's 20 years, you got $100 million, this might be at $99 million.
Yeah, there's nothing magical about that. I mean, I already know what the language is going to say. It's going to say road, street, and bridge purposes. I mean, it's going to be real generic. The detail can come afterwards.
Or?
It's 0.869 mils.
What you come and follow us, did you read it? Got it.
0.869.
So each house is different based on the value of the house? I don't think that's right at all.
How else are you going to pay for it? I mean, the fairest way is a toll road, but they won't let that happen.
No, but how about the same four person house here doesn't pay twice as much as the four person house here that uses the roads just the same? How about the dollar amount per house?
How do you know somebody uses the roads the same? I mean, right now, the list.
How do you know they use them more? They should pay more.
That's why there would be a toll road, but we can't.
No, I'm not talking about toll roads. I'm talking about if it's based off a mill, a guy that has an $800,000 house can pay twice as much as a $400,000 house. How is that fair if they're the same amount of cars and the same people driving?
But how is it a fair way? Taxpayer?
How is it? Why can't you do it per resident?
I don't know that you got any taxing mechanism to do that.
What are we talking about? Geobonds funded typically by ad valorem property taxes.
That's right. That has to be guaranteed by the property values on the ground.
There's no other way to do that?
What he's saying is do it like, no matter how much a house is worth.
$400 a house, $250 a house, whatever
it is.
We don't typically, in just going out for the bond, we don't come up with a financing scheme for that bond unless it is part of like SPLOS where we're dedicating tax dollars to it. This is just, you know, what we're telling the voter, what we're asking the voters is if you issue this debt, we're committing the taxation power of the county to repay it. Now, that's not what we want to do here. We're going to try to get the SPLOS 8 to
pay. But in the meantime, while you're doing it, to put it as a millage rate back in the house, there's not any other way to do it with a solid number.
That's an assessment issue for the taxes.
That's all I'm getting at.
What you?
I don't think the millage is always the fairest way to do it because the guy that has a bigger house pays more. Why? He doesn't necessarily use it more.
Right.
But
That's all I'm getting at.
The size of the house has nothing to do with who uses it more.
Or less.
It doesn't.
So it should have the same amount per household.
But you can't do that with your, I mean, I...
Oh, maybe you can.
No, I mean, well, I'm just saying, that's a, the issue, I understand it, but it's an accessory issue of how they assess.
Some houses have six cars, and some have one.
The only reason why I brought that, you can have six cars all you want, if you have one driver, you're only driving one car at a time.
So is it by driver, or is it by house?
I think it's by house.
I mean, I went from two drivers to four drivers in a period of about 18 months.
And you should pay double. And the only reason why I brought that up is because Mr. Merritt brought up the knowledge on it. Just something to consider.
Way to go, Tim. Way to open that can of worms.
Answering questions.
But he was on board with me for a moment, because he said that's what I'm thinking, early.
On the parking for the 20-year, and will you come up with an estimate?
And I know what you said about don't...
How much is that a house per year?
I love the idea in theory that this won't be a 20-year tax on a bond should the SPOS pass, but I think you do, we do have to consider, the naysayers will say, well, you're going ahead, this is really some kind of leadership, they're going ahead and they're assuming SPOS is going to pass, so now they're sticking us not only with a bond, but they're going to stick us with a SPOS. So, you see what I'm saying?
And we're going to like Georgia 400.
Hey.
And is there another option?
This is why it's going to go to the people to vote on us.
Wait till 2030 when we have managed lanes. That's the other option.
Well, and candidly, at the end of the day, you know, the GO bond, we can say that all we want to in informational pieces, that's our plan, but the reality is what we'll be saying is, this is debt, and it's backed by property. That's right.
Right.
Backed by property, that's right. But the bottom line is, it's not us to vote on this, ultimately it's up to the voters to vote on, and they have to decide if they want it or not. They have to decide if they're going to save 2 hours, 1 hour, 5 hours a week in traffic, how that equates by the year compared to what they're going to be paying, and if it has a value to them in their time and their life, quality of life.
And well, especially when you consider that 400 is going to be a managed lane, and they're going to be paying to drive on it anyway.
If they get in that managed lane, yes.
If they get in that managed lane.
So could we just have a discussion about some of these other projects, mm-hmm. and if, you know, you guys know the customer counts and that customer counts. sorry, wrong business.
Traffic
counts. Thank you, Council. The traffic counts, you know, and the road needs and that sort of thing. I mean, on that, on this list, I mean, where would you put some of these in list of priority?
How much more money are we talking? Are we talking 30 million? You've got
120.
Well,
a total of 120.
Let him get some priorities, and then we'll say if we cross the threshold, we're not comfortable with that line. But fine, but let's not set the threshold first. Okay.
Well, it's really not that many projects. When you get right down to it, we have certain SPLOSH obligations. We know what they are. Castleberry, the board's going to fund. So you could take it off the list. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're going to put it out to bid in a month. So assuming it's awarded and funded, and I say you could take it off the list. You agree, Ken?
I do.
You know, whatever obligations you have, you don't have to fund them with the bond, but you're going to have to fund them.
At some point. Or take them off when they vote on SPLOS 8.
And Brian, didn't you say you felt like Brook Red Road, we had done a lot?
We've done a lot to that, especially when we straighten out Caney, and I think we're close on that. John, we got some information last week, but I think we're moving forward on that. So, yeah. I mean, I just don't think in list of priorities that it's at the top. I mean, I think we've done enough intersection improvements down there, and when we did the intersection improvement at 141 and added that turn lane, it made a big difference.
It may not be at the top in the priorities, it's just an obligation.
Yeah.
You know, and just like I said,
have you met the obligation?
The only thing I'm aware of that we've done is we've done some intersection improvements. Maybe John noted this more, but I think what we advertised was a widening. And I don't think we've done anything that would constitute a widening. Now, it may be, though, that the voters in the area, to the extent we wanted to get rid of that obligation, would say, we've done enough. We're very comfortable abandoning that project to the extent it's widening, fully legitimate.
I think that they'll have an opinion on that when Caney Road is relocated and that intersection is improved.
Which we're making progress on.
Which we're making progress on. Then, so for purposes of this bond, I don't think it needs to go on there myself. I think there's other priorities. Well, we put this whole page on here, but I think there's others.
Oh, and much more, yeah. We've got a transportation plan for the project.
That's right.
We could add to the list, but.
What about, could you go back up to the top and just talk about those Ronald Reagan extensions?
You know, we've requested that those segments be funded in Splash 5, 6, 7. You know, they keep missing the list. I think they're important projects to complete our collector road system. It provides an alternate 400 on the east side of 400. Not only does it provide that alternate, but it provides, you know, for some economic development in the area.
Absolutely.
I think it's important, especially if you get the McGinnis Ferry interchange in.
That's the next stop up.
And, no, I agree with that completely.
I mean, it's, they need to be done.
Both? Can you do one without the other, or?
Well, logically, they both need to be done.
Yes.
You don't. You've already got south of Majors two
dead
lanes.
Dead ends right there, Majors.
To a dead
yes,
end.
It does, right.
And if you go down to Shiloh, you're hop, skipping, a jump down to McFarland, but you got to cross Big Creek with a bridge. So it makes logical sense to do both at the same time and get
and
them
you
done.
Don't know that these numbers are.
I know.
It needs to be updated. You said? I mean, that's $43 million.
We can look at them again, but I think that amount would likely get the projects done. But I have Buddy's staff look at it again. They developed the conceptual design for that. They walked the route. They review it environmentally, so I can have them go back and look at those numbers.
To be honest, if that's what, I mean, that'll be $120 million.
I hear you. I just want to get it all out there. Mm-hmm. I mean, I just want to discuss every one of them. It doesn't.
But
I'm not advocating.
Those projects are not in Splash 7, so you know we have no design money, right of way money, or construction money for those two projects.
And yet, all of these, once Splash comes in, and especially if we're taking some Splash projects and funding them differently, these could get done.
Traffic.
Even without the bond.
I'm in traffic right now.
Well, Castleberry could.
Well,
Castleberry
the rest
is the
of
one.
Them, if the Splash dollars come in for 7?
Well, if more money comes in Splash 7, then we have identified for Splash 7 projects.
What about these old Atlanta?
In A and B, then you would use these transportation funds to complete these projects.
That's correct.
Okay.
That's why I'm
so
not
that
praising
is another
that.
Funding
that's
source.
Right. That's why these two years
Atlanta,
they come available.
What he's saying is these two projects aren't identified in Splash.
I know.
Yeah.
No point. So that's my thing. Why don't we just put those in the bond and let these all go?
But that's
right.
It's a future board decision, just like it was in Splash 6.
Darn expensive.
If extra money is collected and priority A and B projects are completed, then the board decides where to put that extra money. Logically, it would go for completing transportation projects that are carrying over in Splash 8
anyway.
Those are going to be, those two outside of the state roads are going to have the biggest economic impact.
Yeah.
There's no doubt about it. I mean, that's going to
and
be
we
like,
have no funding
it's going to be
for
like
them.
North Point Parkway,
correct?
Yeah.
Know,
yeah.
15 years
with
ago.
With the interchange and the mall, assuming it's going to come, you need those two segments.
And if they're in there, that might even entice the mall more.
Yeah, I agree.
They're collector roads too.
Which is, yeah, 400 gets shut down, and that's, you know, that's your alternate. Otherwise, so that's right, unless you try to go over nine, which is a disaster, right? And right now you got people jumping off of McFarland, cutting through Bluegrass and up Stony Point. That's two lane road there, exactly, curvy two lane road. Yep, all right, so what about, so we're confident these will get funded in Splash.
They add up.
Well,
right?
In Splash,
seven.
We're not confident in Splash 7, but in Splash.
John, 8. What do they add up to minus Ronald Reagan?
Well, Ronald Reagan's not in Splash
not
7.
Either.
Okay, well, what do those add up to? About 99 million?
Well, if you, let's look at it.
Minus
well,
the Castleberry, you're 92.
97.
If you take Brookwood off, you take Castleberry off. You know, it's up to you guys if you think it's McFarland. Adding another two lanes to that segment of McFarland could wait.
Yes.
McGinnis Ferry Road, you know, there's $18 million there. That's only half of it, but it needs to be done.
It does.
Do you want to leave that in there? I would say yes.
If there's less than 100 million, it'll be taken care of by the remainder of SPOSS 7.
Well, it may have been collected.
Right.
Now, Old Atlanta, that's why Old Atlanta Phase 4 is in here, but if you're confident you're going to get the Priority B money, that segment's already funded as a Priority B project, SPOSS 7, so you can take that off. But now, SPOSS, Old Atlanta Phase 5, it's not listed to be funded in SPOSS 7. So if you're confident you're going to collect extra money and fund Old Atlanta Phase 5, then you don't put it in here. And if you don't, you have to fund it in the future SPOSS.
Yeah, but Old Atlanta Phase 5 isn't
still less
this big a deal. I don't think.
So if you want to leave that off of here, I mean, that's up to you. But if you want to assure it gets funded in the next 10 years, you might want to leave it on.
John, the entire
I wouldn't want to see it next 10 years, but it's not something that's a priority.
Well,
it's like Bookwood Road.
You're going to have to complete all your A and B projects in SPOSS 7. You might have funded SPOSS 8.
Yeah.
And SPOSS 8 would have to pass, and that's probably going to be 2020-2021.
Mm-hmm.
So you're looking at least 2021 for construction and 2023-24 completion. If you can wait 10 years, then don't
put it. Let me ask you something. Yes. Do all these have to get done before we go back and do this Category B project? Because that Category B project is probably a bigger priority than some of these others that are listed on here.
Well, I mean, since these projects have been placed on SPOSS, oh, we're going back to SPOSS 5, we have been just in a flux of changing priorities from the board.
Exactly.
So when you ask me which one has to be done first, I can tell you that's going to be subject to the board's discretion. They just have to be done.
But this is a B project.
Yep,
you
but it was a B project for SPLOS 6, but in SPLOS 5,
seven.
We, oh, SPLOS 7, but in SPLOS 5, when the project originated, it wasn't a SPLOS
okay.
B.
That's right.
Right.
See, so if you collect B money in 7, you're going to have to complete the B projects in 7 first before you complete projects that are not currently funded.
That is true. That's what
So you would have to complete Phase 4 first before you can move forward to Phase 5 and SPOSS 7.
Yeah, I agree with that.
On that list, I was going to ask, the two Old Atlanta, are those some that we're already doing, or is that something different?
That's what we were just talking about.
They're under design, but Phase 5 is not funded, and Phase 4 is a Priority B.
And I'm not advocating for Phase 5 to be done right now. I think Phase 4, even though it's a B project, is probably bigger
Old Atlanta?
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah,
it
phase
is.
Four is probably
it is.
A bigger
Old Atlanta's terrible.
To 7B.
But what I'm saying
but
is that's a B project.
But we can reprioritize it if you need be.
But what?
Yeah.
Well,
but
you can't move 5 in front of 4 because 4 is already listed for
gotcha.
Priority B funding.
But I was just saying 4
if
right now is probably a bigger priority than 5. Just today.
So you're thinking about taking it and putting it in the bond because that's what you can't do any other way.
Yeah,
okay.
I just wonder.
So 5 is up to the board too. If you want to bond it or you want to stand a chance of having to wait till SPOSS 8, which
yeah.
could be you not have it constructed for 10 years.
Yeah, okay. All righty.
Pilgrim Mill Road.
It's going to be 800 million.
I mean,
start coming in 2 years from now on SPOSS 7.
That's
so
an extension
how much
of the city's widening ends, widening out to 4 lanes across the bridge over to Freedom Parkway.
Who pays for the bridge?
That's included there. We pay for
it. I think that is low priority.
Now, it's just it's bumper to bumper from every afternoon from the bridge over to Holtzclaw, you know, through Freedom Parkway, and it backs down the ramp to 400. But that's up to the board. It's an obligation.
But, I mean,
but it's up to the board.
It is, and how big we want to, I mean, with how big do you want this bond to be?
Right.
You don't want to scare people either.
No.
You want to keep the most priority projects on it.
If I can be the devil's advocate, wouldn't it be nice, though, to get particularly these SPLOSS 5 projects?
Get them
clean.
Get them done for SPLOSS 8.
And
yes.
then when you're dealing with SPLOSS 8, we're not even
you're dealing with clean
thinking
money.
About
yeah.
this.
Otherwise, we're looking at all the money we take in SPLOSS 8 to have to go back and
pay for these
that were approved in 2003. you know, 15 years earlier.
Yeah.
Yes.
We're getting to be like, you know.
You know, but I think it's worth noting some of the other bonds. You know, I was seventh fastest growing county. I like to look at what the other six are doing. And transportation bonds, the one in Texas, you know, this they're coming out for their second transportation bond at $250 million. Now, granted, they're the fastest growing county in the nation, and we're the seventh. Just to throw out the kind of money we're talking about, and the two, you know, if you're up at 250 or whatever, keep in mind, one third of that is in cooperation with GDOT. You know, it's not their local
project. Yeah, we're doing it's state not, projects, it's but it's to help the citizens.
That's true, but I think it would be nice, like he said, to have a clean slate at the end of this FLOST, you know.
I think we've got, before we can even seriously know, we've got to know what it means to a tax bill. Yeah,
absolutely. We ought to be able to say to somebody on a $350,000 house,
think we make
it costs you $100.
Say, oh, we're going 250 because 250 sounds good, but we're not knowing what
you're
the
right.
tax consequence
we need to know that. And that's a conversation for another meeting. But it might, it'd be nice to know, just from where I sit, you know, if we're in the 150 to 200 or 200 to 250 or 1 to 150 range, you know. Somewhere in that area, just be kind of nice to know that. But
what's the total if we knock out the ones on five?
John, I think 70 to 80.
Okay, we're talking about that before, but
that doesn't include the 42 for the Majors Road, the two up here. You're talking about just the yellow, right? You're not talking about those two up there.
Exactly.
That's 42 for the two at the top, Ronald Reagan.
Yeah.
Well.
Is that not a SPLOST carryover?
No.
Okay.
Well, if you do take Brookwood off, like you're talking about, if you take Castleberry off, like you're talking about,
and they don't have any fluff with any sidewalks and these trails.
If you take McFarland Parkway off, you leave 18 from McGinnis Ferry, so you got 18.
74.
If you do Old Atlanta Phase 5, then that's, you're up to what, 32? And you're talking about leaving Pilgrim Mill Road off?
No, I guess include
if it's on FLOST 5.
32, so you're up about 42. And Union Hill Road and the Bridge, 54 million.
Roughly $150 million bond. I don't think that McFarland needs to go to six lanes just yet. I just don't think
the reason that project was originally put on was for the mall.
Right.
So at some point you're going to need that.
Yeah.
Well, after the mall's built,
right. Then you pick up.
You know what, though, you get your interchange on McGinnis Ferry. You may not.
That's right. And if we build these collector roads down there,
when the original traffic study was done for the mall, at full build out, it needed the interchange. It needed the widening of McGinnis Ferry. It needed the widening of Union Hill Road.
Full build out could be 15, 20 years. We have time to go back.
It needed additional lanes. So yeah, that was anticipating the future needs of the build out of the mall. Mm-hmm. That's why those projects were put on. That's why you had lanes on McFarland. That's but the lanes on McFarland were originally the full length of McFarland all the way to 9. But you also had the Union Hill project. That's why we designed it. We bought right away because that was for the mall. And the interchange is for the mall, and then extended Ronald Reagan up.
But it's hard to here we got one project going from 4 to 6 lanes, and it could dump into a 2-lane road and even get a ferry.
I agree. You know, it's an obligation, but it could
done.
Wait.
Yeah, we need to get that done first, no doubt.
Hi.
So that puts us down to about $54 million.
Which ones
were you dropping? The interchange, if you put 10 on, the ones I
hand my pen.
Dropped
off.
Brookwood, Casper.
Yeah,
you know, they Brookwood, Castleberry, McFarland.
That's taking it to 6 lanes.
So you do McGinnis,
Old Atlanta 4 is coming off because it's in SPLOST
7B. Okay.
Now I assume we would leave Phase 5 on there since it's not funded.
So you got 18 million, a 14 million, a 12-2, and a 10, or a 9-5-5. You got those four projects.
18, 14 gives you 32, plus about 10, 42, plus 12, is 54.
Are these not also listed on 7?
All the ones in yellow are listed.
So you're going to have 80 to 100?
But they're not funded.
I understand, okay. Gotcha.
So that would, the more of those you can get complete, the more cleaner your slate will be.
Yeah, and see, all of them are listed on five.
I understand, because you're going to have somewhere between 80 to 100 or a little more coming in still after the jail's paid for courthouse. So what does that leave left? If we put these on the bond, what does that leave left?
I'd have to pull the list out and look at it. You're going to have to complete everything in A plus B.
I understand. But do you think you have 80 to 100, and those lists are left?
And, well, all projects together, I think. Seems like there is. Yeah, would you go get?
Because that, then you would be completely.
Spot seven, A and B.
Does that make sense? And you will, if you do this on the bond and you have that about, that's not left, you will be clean. Are we, are you in the meeting line thing? That's why you don't do that.
I'm not.
I am too. So I dressed up so nice.
Yeah, where did you get that shirt?
I'll get you, I got one for you. Will it fit? I'll bring you one. I got one for everybody.
Did you put that on your expense account?
I don't know, no. Yeah, my own personal expense account. I don't know if it'll fit you.
So you're,
Did you get that from Brother?
No.
Your SPOSH A transportation's at $69,710, so about $70 million there. Your priority B.
Candy's using your.
Project list is $24 million. So what you're going to need, or just for transportation only, it's going to be about $95 million.
That'll be around, very close.
All right, so that's something we need to do at our next meeting, is finalize that, our local list.
This might be an interesting add-on. And this will get you cleaned up by the end of seven.
So the other thing I wanted to just bring up, if you don't mind for discussion again, is back to the language about letting the public know that what we want to do is come out for a bond and then come out to try to pay for it in SPOSH A if they're, you know, forewarn them or, you know, tell them. But is that possible to put that in the language to give them some surety?
In the language and the ballot?
Yeah. Should Forsyth County come out for a bond that would be paid back by SPOSH A to SPOSH A?
No, and the reason is because you'd be adding contingency on contingency. I mean, if you vote on this and approve this, then you'll be asked to vote again on something in the future. That,
well, it could only say if, you know, if it passes, then it'll go through. But if not,
I don't think so.
But no. Can we, as a board, do a resolution that says that's
absolutely
our intention?
Absolutely. And to the extent that there is a committee that we create from time to time, or that are created to go out and try to speak at town halls and try to tell people what's going on, they could certainly be advised that that's our plan. The board could adopt a resolution to that effect. The board could put it in any sort of informational flyers that we kick out. All of that's true. It just won't be on the ballot.
If you clean this up the way you're suggesting, and you've got about 87 to 90 million left for SPOSH 7 to take care of, it's feasible to believe it's going to be another 100 million collected, between 80 and 100 million collected, that will leave it clean. So SPOSH 8 at that moment will have no burdens on it like most others have as they carry over. And it is correct, it is very reasonable to believe we'll be money to pay back this bond, or at least a large portion of it.
Well, I mean, yeah, that would actually be part of our SPOSH 8 referendum and ballot language. Now that would be very clear. I mean, in SPOSH 8, we'd be saying to pay, you know, to reimburse, to pay back.
And we'll be paying it back every year anyways through the millage till you get to that point, if it passing or not. So your bond will actually be a little less.
That's right.
By the time
you do your debt service.
So it's a 10-year note or a 20-year note?
Oh, you can do 20.
That way the payments are
lower. You've got to do it.
That's right. That's correct.
And you got to do it. You have to assume the worst and assume that the SPOSH would not pass.
So how much, didn't we have a thing on park and rec bond right now on a $100 million, so on a
$400,000 or $300,000
house, what did it roughly cost somebody? Was it like $100, $150?
I remember that number being very close to that. I can't.
So, I mean, we're kind of in the neighborhood there, or, you know, there's a creative multiplier there, but we're talking about, if I'm remembering and doing this correct, about, you know, less than $200 a person for a household, or
yep,
$150. $100 a household.
Yep.
For
save hours.
$150
of traffic. Something they'll have to decide if they want or not.
I would be thrilled if 369 to Coal Mountain to Hammond's Crossing would be improved.
How thrilled?
Very thrilled. You mean double mine?
What kind of a dance would you do?
Then you look at the SPLOST dollars you would create to some of this, freeing up some of this road and getting that mall project going at the county line.
I mean, when I think about Walmart coming in right here on 369 by this station and what that's going to do to this, I mean, it's going to be a nightmare.
Yeah, just like Buddy said, if you don't do something, then probably nothing's going to be done.
I mean,
on 369.
I mean, the state essentially has, there's no money.
Well, not just that, you can't get logical sperm miles.
Right, so the only way this can get done is through the way we're doing it.
Are we pretty much wrapped up?
I think we need to decide. I think we need to talk about another meeting.
Before we get rescheduled, so the action items today are, Buddy is going to, or may have drafted a letter.
I'm getting there, I'm going to work a job, we'll get done with this meeting.
And then we're going to request, and I'll handle that with Mr. Merritt, we'll handle trying to get a special call meeting for Thursday morning to come ratify the letter, hand deliver it down to GDOT. In the meantime, get another meeting for the Transportation Committee to talk finance. With the ultimate goal, if all the moving parts work together, is to have an agenda item on the August 12th work session for ratification of a resolution calling for a GO bond in November, and have that resolution ready to go, be prepared.
What is this list? This is what?
Yeah. As far as a meeting on Thursday afternoon, I just want to tell you there's
Thursday morning now.
Thursday morning.
Are you saying Thursday morning?
Yeah. Okay. Early, 10 a.m.
That was a joke.
You miss my 8 o'clock meetings, don't you? Because we have GMRC that day. So.
Yes.
I need to know soon. I probably have to bring my little sweet, kind Tasmanian granddaughter.
What time is it?
What did you just say?
Well, they
my
have
sweet,
a
kind.
Workforce
sweet,
development
hun.
Thing, and I think
she's
it's
a wild child.
Early,
so I think I have to leave. She has a lot of
energy. Well, I think I'm talking about a 15-minute special meeting at like 9 o'clock.
Do you feel it 50
minutes? No. Take it easy. If we look at this list under funding summary, is that our general priority of projects starting with 400 McFarland to 20? Second priority is 420 to 369. Third priority, Post Road. Fourth priority is the 369-400 continuous flow intersection. And last would be State Route 369.
I would say that somewhere the McGinnis Ferry interchange needs to be up there.
Yeah, it's got to be in.
You know, like maybe number two. And then if we do all that in a bond, do we really prioritize with a bond? I mean, here's
no.
the list. We've built six roads at one time.
No, and they don't want
this
us
is,
to do 400 without 369 improvement. That was what Ruby kept saying.
I think this priority was just really for DOT purposes, to let them understand what our priorities are and to try to get their commitment.
I don't think you put it as a priority.
I don't either. I think they're all number
I don't.
One priority.
I think they are. I do too. Because they were the
These
ones
are our
that said,
number one priorities.
When we talked about, exactly.
All 56 million.
When we talked about doing 400 from McFarland up to 20, Rudy was the one that said you can't do that if you don't improve 369.
Yeah.
He said you've got to get 369 improved.
Yeah, I think it's a package too. I
mean, which they then pulled out a plan to show us that they're already moving forward.
Okay.
Well, we ain't going to have to jump start them.
But I kind of do agree with Brian is, we have a separate agreement on the interchange, and we're going to have to put interchange money in the bond, so why not go ahead and add it to the list?
Got that in the statement.
Yeah, and we can have Buddy do that.
That way that everybody knows we're serious about it.
This is a package deal.
And it gets done so much faster.
And even though Miss Ferry is a county road, the intersection is a state project.
Mm-hmm.
And, we're going to assist with funding at a $10 million local level with bond funding, if that's what you're putting on the referendum. And and that be on the list.
Okay. Are there any other roads that aren't on this list for anybody? Only one other one I wanted to talk about possibly is Old Alpharetta. What's your thoughts on that, or if that's something that...
Well, it's a future widening project in our transportation plan, so it's just, it's like...
As far as the level of need, do you have it as a D road or an F road or that bad, or do you know?
You know, I don't know off the top of my head. I believe it's listed as a long-range project.
Just get your free vote. You can do it like you did Castleberry.
But that can move up.
That's a great idea.
On the SPOS 8.
I've seen that before.
I mean, if we can wipe out these, then you can put Old Alpharetta and different things on James Burgess, things on SPOS 8.
On the next SPOS 8, are you? I just wanted to bring it up.
If you get the connection with Ronald Reagan, it's going to take pressure off of Old Alpharetta and Shiloh and all those.
And of course, we're putting a signal on doing the intersection improvement. That's going to help there at Caney and Old Alpharetta. But it could probably wait a few years. But it's going to need to be widened.
Is that Gateway?
I think SPOS 7, we discontinued in 2019, so I mean, you'll be starting to put together your project list in 2017.
We just need a right turn lane.
And that's a go-around lane. At Gateway, Highway 9 heading south, can you use a left lane, left go-around lane?
I think they've run out of money on equipment.
I didn't get either one of mine that they promised.
That's so funny. They told us they had it. We rode around with them.
We gave them a list of projects.
And they awarded. They said that those two in my district we were getting.
That's why we need this in writing.
And they said they run out of money. That's why you need it. Yeah.
Why we need this in writing.
All right. Ron, motion to adjourn.
Sure. Sir, motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
A motion and a second. Any discussion? Not, please vote on the motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? There are none. That motion passes unanimously. We're going to stand adjourned at 5:56.
Good meeting.
Yeah, yes, it was. And we need to probably set another one.
Yeah, we got to move. Soon.
Be on the lookout for an email from me.
Somebody from finance will be here. Maybe your special meeting, if it started a little earlier, could be run a little longer, and we could talk more about our projects.
But when will Dave be back? Do we know? We could get the numbers.
Next week, Monday or Tuesday.
Do they have somebody in finance? Could get us some general information?
What you wanted on a $350,000 home?
Yes, 10-year, 10-year and 20-year.
What sounds like?
Yeah, 150 10 million.
And 20.
Yeah.
150, or you want it just in a 100 million increment?
No, 150 like and 200 million.
200 million?
Either one. Just find out what the spread is.
10 and 20 year bond, 150, 200 million, $350,000 home.
We've adjourned. We've adjourned, yes, sir.
Thanks, Ken. Oh, Ken, did you need me for something?
No, I got it for you.
You call me. I was in my
phone. I just wanted to update you on that phone call.
Okay. Thank you, buddy. I feel like when I say your name, I'm like, buddy. Like, you're my buddy. Like, it's not like, buddy.
You're my buddy.
You got a second?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, what we'll do is we draft it up. We'll send it to you, and you tweak it. It'll be for the chairman's signature, and then you send it to the parish.
Sounds good. I'll be looking out for it.
Okay. All right.
Thanks.
Thank you.